Good morning, YouTube. What's going on? It's Mesa back at it with some Destiny 2. All right, Curse of Osiris is going to be here on Tuesday, December 5th, as well as Season 2 for Destiny 2. And we got a number of stuff to cover. This is going to be a video all about kind of last-minute preparation, but also some preparation and things you want to consider, because we're going to be getting two updates, one for December 5th and then one for December 12th. December 12th is when we're getting the Dawning. That's going to be the next live event. Bungie put out a tweet yesterday, and they updated a blog post regarding the raid keys. The raid keys are now going to disappear every single Tuesday at reset. So if you have any keys right now, you might want to go in and open up all those chests, get a fire team together. I know for me personally, I really don't need anything. I'm not hoarding legendaries, I'm hoarding exotic engrams, which we will talk about in a little bit. So yeah, they are going back to removing the keys every reset. There is some sort of glitch within the game right now where I think if you create a new character or do something, you end up losing all of your keys. So if you got a bunch of keys, go into the Leviathan, open up all those chests. Now, speaking of the raid, Deej had tweeted out that they're going to forecast the opening of the new raid lair is going to be the week after Curse of Osiris launches. Now, someone had chimed in regarding, are you going to be tracking Worlds First? And then Deej replied, I don't think we're going to call Worlds First for this one. Play it for fun whenever it fits into your life. Now, at this point, no one knows what the raid lairs are. When I went to Bungie Studios to play Curse of Osiris, they did not tell us a single thing. That statement that they're not calling Worlds First leaves me a little concerned, just because I'm kind of expecting or hoping that this raid lair is going to be basically another raid, a raid within the Leviathan. They did say it's going to be shorter, but then again, if we think about it, if you don't use the underbelly, the Leviathan raid we have right now is pretty darn long. They did say in one of the reveal streams there's going to be some puzzles, there's going to be a final boss. They didn't say bosses, not plural. Which again leaves me a little concerned, because if it's going to be a raid experience, I'm hoping lots of bosses. But then again, maybe it could be some sort of horde mode, and maybe Uncle Kallus is hiding in the basement. He's been in the underbelly the whole time. I don't know, because the regular Leviathan raid is just all a big test. A test for us to prove ourselves to Kallus. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section. But one thing lastly to chime in on the raid, I really hope with the next update that they do fix all the cheeses. My crew and I, look, I've never cheesed it before, but my crew, they LFG a lot, and they run into a lot of people who, like, literally cheesed it every time and have no idea how to do some of the encounters. So, Bungie, if you're listening, I hope you fix the cheeses and some of the glitches, like the respawning glitch. That's a nightmare, too. So, here's how it's going to go down with regards to the launch of Curse of Osiris. So, we're going to have maintenance Tuesday morning at 8 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. Dylan DMG04 from Bungie tweeted out, we have a time now that it should be over. Should be over 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. Once it's over, we could start playing Curse of Osiris. Now, the time between 8 a.m. Pacific Standard Time and 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, you can go in and preload Curse of Osiris. So as soon as the maintenance is done, you log in and start playing Curse of Osiris. Keep it locked in here. You guys know me. I stream only on YouTube, so I'll be streaming all week long. Now, before we get into some last-minute preparation, just want to chime in on this real quick, because when the press get together, they're worse than a sewing circle. Look, the lighthouse area, the patrol area, it is small. That's not the entire patrol area. They did not talk about the Infinite Forest. None of us were allowed to record the Infinite Forest once we were in patrol. It was actually locked off. So yeah, the lighthouse patrol area is small, but you guys have not seen the past, present, or future. Well, you saw some of it in the reveal stream of the Infinite Forest. That's going to be where all the stuff goes down. Now, with regards to updates, for December 5th, when Curse of Osiris launches, that's when all the armor ornaments are going to be. So the vendors, they said Vanguard, Trials, Crucible, Iron Banner, Factions, that's all going to kick off December 5th. You'll be able to do things within the game to earn ornaments for your armor. Now, after that, we get an update on December 12th. That's when a lot more stuff is coming. That's when we could start grinding for those masterwork weapons, right? That's when Xur is going to start selling faded engrams and also 3 of coin consumables that last 4 hours. One thing to note with the faded engram, if you're hoarding a ton of legendary shards, you're not going to be able to just go in and just blow all your shards and get every exotic in the game that first week Xur comes to town with those things. It does say in the update, you can buy one of those per week. Now, what I'm trying to find out right now, and if I find out, I will leave it in the pinned comment. Is it account-based, one exotic from Xur per week, or is it per character? I'm guessing right now it's going to be per character, which I'm fine with. Three exotic Engrams. There's going to be a bunch of new exotics coming with Curse of Osiris, guys. We've seen hints at them. I know everyone thinks a Red Death hand cannon is coming, but I'm going to reserve judgment until we see the list in Destiny sets. Remember Red Spectre? That was not exotic, and it basically was a take on Red Death, but an auto rifle that came with the Taken King. But we'll have to see if it's going to be a true exotic or just another legendary, kind of like Red Spectre or something. But it does look cool nonetheless. So with that being said, I would definitely clear out your vault. Deej did tweet out that there's going to be no changes to the vault and that it is on their list of things to do. Now, we know there's going to be a ton of new armor and weapons to grind for within Destiny 2 Curse of Osiris. I will say this, guys. I went to the tower when I was at Bungie playing Curse of Osiris. I can't tell you about it, but let's just say I did see some things, okay? So you might want to clear out your vault. Just get rid of stuff that you don't need, duplicates. I just have a whole bunch of crap in my vault. I don't know why half of it's there, but I'm getting rid of anything I don't need or don't like. Now, even though in the state of Destiny 2, it does say that the Masterworks are going to be available for drops December 12th, they do say here that December 5th, for players chasing a World Legendary or looking for Masterworks, Master Raul will sell some of his rumored hoard of Legendary Engrams for Legendary Shards. Now, also December 5th, not December 12th, Banshee. Let's talk about him. So, for players wanting to clear some mod inventory space, rare quality mods will dismantle to gunsmith materials and have a chance to produce legendary quality mods. For players chasing specific legendary mods, including legendary kinetic mods, thank you, Bungie, because those are certainly a pain to craft. It says Banshee will offer a selection of specific legendary mods for direct purchase, with a selection that's going to rotate daily, yes, and cost legendary shards and mod components. So let's talk about some last minute preparation. And as you can see, I'm hoarding exotic Engrams. Now, why am I not decrypting them? Well, because I already have every exotic in the game except for one. But look at it this way, guys. They're going to give me duplicates now anyway. They're working, I think December 12th is when the duplication thing is going to be fixed, where you keep getting the same exotic over and over. So I'm holding on to my exotic Engrams for when that is fixed, and then I'll start popping them. The way I look at it, guys, yes, they are timestamped with the power level to it, but hey, if it could give me a new exotic and I could infuse something into it, why not? Why would I decrypt them now? Now, you could also see I just have a boatload of the Destination tokens, Crucible tokens, Vanguard tokens, etc. Look, I was not able to go look at any of the other destinations. Now, we know Brother Vance, he's going to have an inventory of stuff to get. I don't know if the destinations, they might get a refresh, guys. Every DLC we've had with Destiny 1, usually all the vendors get a refresh, right? So that's why I'm holding on to all my Destination tokens. I'm a little light on the Titan tokens, as you can see, only in 254, over 400 on the others. But I am hoarding everything because I did see some new stuff at the tower. Can't say what it was or what it is. And also, I'm wondering if the destinations all over the place, they might have some new stuff too. And remember, the destination vendors, they rotate their power number every half hour. So if you get lucky, who knows, they may rotate and be a great way to get some gear to infuse, even if they don't have new stuff. I'm going to guess that they're going to be power sensitive, meaning that they're going to give you something appropriate to your power level. And you know that the vendors on the destinations, they rotate their power number every half hour. Sometimes it goes up, sometimes it goes down. So one of them, let's say I'm at 310 power. Hey, I might just go wait around some of the destination NPCs, see if they can give me something 312 or something. I don't know. Regardless if they sell new stuff or not, I'm going to wait around and see once my power level creeps up a bit after the first week and start waiting around some of those destination NPCs and maybe get some higher power stuff. So that's going to do it for the video, guys. Leave a hashtag made it to the end if you did make it to the end. And a quick favor, when Destiny 2 did launch, I got a ton of tweets and messages. Hey, Mesa, I got this exotic that you don't have. Do you want to use my account to review it? Guys, I will take you up on that offer. I'm throwing my morals out. I used to just wait until I got every exotic and then review it, but I think I hurt myself in terms of growth in the long run. If you do get an exotic and you'd like me to let you use your account to review it and give you a shout out, by all means, shoot me a tweet or leave me a message when Curse of Osiris hits. That's it, guys. Do me a favor. Drop a like in this video, only if you see fit. Follow me on the Twitter @MesaSean. Check out my stream, usually and always on YouTube, and that's it. I'm out of here like Vladimir.